we have already recovered almost 80% of the job losses that hit IBA companies in the crash in 2007. That's a really strong performance. And the last 2 years alone, 2011 and 2012, have seen a cumulative increase of 9% in IDA employment.
We have exceeded the targets in terms of gross job creation by international companies, and some of the most ambitious and creative companies in the world are picking Ireland. In terms of job losses, this is the best year in over a decade, and the lowest level of job losses. So this is a really strong performance by international companies. Over the last 2 years, you can say that the number of people at work in IDA companies has increased by 9%. That's a very strong performance in any language.
The greatest net jobs in over a decade, certainly we only went back as far as 2002, but it's 6570, it's certainly the strongest since before then. And job losses down quite significantly, they've been dropping now for the 3 years in a row. And the 6152 is actually the lowest number of job losses again in over a decade.
I think Ireland's reputation has improved dramatically over the last 18 months. You know, if you compare it to what it was like at the back end of 2010, that was really problematic from a foreign direct investment point of view. Those concerns about Ireland, I think people are looking now, if you look at the names of who's investing in Ireland, both existing clients and new ones, the confidence in Ireland is very, very high.
A couple of days before Christmas, IBM published the global location trends. It shows that Ireland remains the number one in the world for inward investment by quality and value. And we're number two in Europe for the number of investment jobs per capita. And that number two in Europe translates into number four in the world. So we continue to do well from a market share point of view.
Well, clearly we're winning jobs in these key sectors, both because of the decisions of government to double the output of graduates in these fields, but also because we have a deep labour pool and people do see that Ireland is a good place to do business in the ICT area. So I think we have positioned ourselves very strongly, but we need to continue to do that. And we need to see, obviously, students are picking their career options for next year. The message is very strong there, that technology, mathematics, engineering, these are the skills in very strong demand by companies who are growing in Ireland.
We've always had competition, but we've noticed that as countries come under pressure economically, they're turning more and more to foreign direct investment. So in particular, the Netherlands, the UK and Switzerland in the last year have certainly emerged as much stronger competitors, and particularly a lot of them are changing their corporation tax code. And particularly for capital intensive industries, they're introducing a new scheme particularly aimed at the pharmaceutical industry, but at the same time we don't compete just on tax alone. We have a very, very strong cluster in the sectors that Ireland excels in. You know, the talent pool is very, very important. How good is the track record? So tax is one element, but one element. Oh, if you were only looking at tax, you wouldn't come to Ireland.
Do you think that this growth is sustainable for 2013, and do you think what can be done by the government to continue the momentum?
Well, obviously the Action Plan for Jobs 2013 will outline a whole new suite of measures, and we will be looking at what additional actions we can take. From the point of view of IDA, they will have again a very strong target to seek to meet next year. It will be as strong as the one last year, so they are, you know, they are committed to deliver what they achieved last year, and that's really you know, best we can do is to keep a focus on the opportunities and seek to keep up this very strong high performance and do other things across the economy to make sure that it's easy to create business in Ireland.
We do have a pipeline, certainly the next 3 to 4 to 5 months, and that will deliver. You'll see announcements starting as early as later this week into the beginning of next week. But it is a constant thing we have to go out and generate. Like, you cannot see all of the business yet that we will deliver in 2013. That's work in progress.